Well, good evening, everyone. Thanks for coming out this evening. I know it's wet and nasty outside, but thanks for braving the elements and coming. For those of you who don't know me, I am Ward 5 Councilor Kirsten Hughes. I recognize many of you here. And of course, this area is also shared by Councilor Ian Kane, who unfortunately could not be here. He's out of town on a work commitment. So he did ask that that I let you folks know. He has been in constant contact with FoxRock regarding this program and this rollout and the deal here with the medical center. He and I have also spoken, so I'm going to report back to him. We have sign-in sheets outside. If you didn't have an opportunity to do that, if you would please sign in. It just gives us an opportunity to email you either plans or to give folks update, just collect more information. So this evening, I know the folks from FoxRock are going to present a couple of different things regarding the medical center, not only about the space there now, which I know many of you are very familiar with, being neighbors, but also what the future might hold for that site, as well as some of the aspects of the sale that just went through to FoxRock and some of their plans. So I want to thank them. They actually were really vocal and very active, very proactive in reaching out to myself, also to the Neighborhood Association. I know there are other neighborhood associations that are affected by this, but they were very proactive, so I want to thank them for their cooperation. And I know that this meeting is for you to get your questions answered and to listen about the project. So what I'd like to do is just to have them go through their presentation first, and then we'll do a question and answer period after. I think that that's really the best way, because sometimes folks have questions along the way. Maybe your question will get answered throughout the presentation. Here this evening, I just want to recognize a few folks. We have Councilor at Large, Noel DeVona is here. Noel, I don't know where you are, but I can't even see you. Oh, geez. Oh, okay, that's fine. Also, Planning Director Jim Fatsies is here, and a representative from the Mayor's Office, Chris Walker, is here as well. Did I miss anybody from the city? Of course, Jen Manning from my office is here, and she's, I thank her. This is extra work, so thank you, Jen, for being here. And with that, again, we'll have them present some of the aspects of the program, the deal, and then also some of the things that they see as a future use for that particular space, and then we'll take questions. So at this time, I'd like to welcome Chet from FoxRock, who's going to give us a preview of what's to come. Chet.
Good evening, everybody. My name is Chet Klein. I'm with FoxRock Properties. With me tonight is Chris Real and Jason Ward, who will be joining me on stage shortly, as well as members of our team at FoxRock. Jess is going to be taking notes, so if we don't have any answers for questions that you ask tonight, we'll follow up. Kai Lau is here. He's available during the Q&A to translate in Mandarin and Cantonese if needed. I am going to take a seat and invite Jason and Chris to join me on stage, and we will get underway. First, I want to thank the Central Middle School for accommodating us this evening. Thank you to Councilor Hughes, the Council's office, and the Mayor's office for facilitating this as well. We see tonight as really an introduction of FoxRock Properties to the community and the start of an ongoing dialogue with the community. We are not new to Quincy, but we're new to the Hill, and we believe in being a good neighbor. We also really believe that the former Quincy Medical Center is the most important project that our company has going right now. It's very important to us. It's what gets us out of bed in the morning. And more importantly, we feel that a true responsibility to the community to get this right. There's a lot of great history up there, and we look to start a new chapter. With that in mind, I'm going to pass it to Jason Ward, who's the founding partner of FoxRock, to give you a little bit more information about our company.
Hey, so who is FoxRock? It's probably a question that some of you folks have that I want to answer. And I will start by talking about the people. FoxRock was founded by a South Shore family, the Hale family. Some of you may have heard of our co-founder, Rob Hale. He co-founded another company called Granite Telecommunications. He co-founded Granite and FoxRock, both here in Quincy, and that's not an accident. Their family's been on the South Shore for many generations. His mother, our other co-founder, Judith Hale, she's from Braintree. She grew up about a mile from Five Corners, and her whole life she grew up Christmas shopping in Quincy Center. So the Hales know Quincy well, and it's where they're from, and it's important to them to do business in the communities that we live in, because one of the things that's important to us is where we do business. We try to improve the communities that we're in. Who we are as a company, we get together, my teammates and I, we get together once a week and we have a staff meeting, talk about what we're working on. And every week, we start every one of those meetings by saying aloud that building strong relationships is the most important part of our business. So, FoxRock as a company, we own 22 properties. It's all on Route 3, South Shore, Quincy, down to Plymouth. We have done, like I said, we own 22 properties. A handful of them have been redevelopment, repositioning, or building new buildings. And sort of our DNA and the things we focus on are medical uses and educational uses. Some of you may be familiar with South Shore Medical Center in Norwell. We're proud of that one. We built that building. We partnered with South Shore Medical Center. It's a 90,000 square foot. It's got primary care. It's got a bunch of specialty groups in it. And we look at that and we say, Norwell's got something. There's no reason a building like that is not in Quincy. We don't, probably same as a lot of you, we look at Quincy and say, why is there something like that not in Quincy? And we're not here to tell you tonight that we have the answer, but it's in our DNA to ask that question and to try to answer it, and that's part of why we like the potential opportunity here in Quincy. So, now we can move on to the next one. So, Libby Wellness Center, that's a building, it was an industrial building in Weymouth. When it was built, I can assure you nobody had medical uses in mind, but we bought it, we repositioned it, it's now a fully 100% medical building. We're pretty proud of the service it provides to Weymouth. That's just an example of a building that we bought that it wasn't really obvious what to do with it, and we figured out a way to turn it into a medical building. Longwater Place, that was the old WearGuard headquarters. It was a 250,000 square foot manufacturing facility. Believe me, nobody knew what to do with it. There was nobody in line behind us when we bought it because most everybody thought you needed to tear it down. But we figured out a way to repurpose it, reposition it, and now we feel like it's the sort of the center of the campus of Assiniboine Park down in Norwell. It's a real flagship building for us. We've got a great roster of commercial tenants in the building, and it's just another example of us buying a building that was built for one thing and figuring out a way to turn it into a higher and better use. So I mentioned, I think, in addition to the medical, we are really focused on educational uses, educational opportunities. In Plymouth, we just built and just opened a 20,000 square foot expansion to the what's called the Pilgrim Area Collaborative. That is a special needs school that serves kids from five school districts, Plymouth and South. Five counties. Five counties, Plymouth and South. We got involved in that project largely because we did a bigger one, which is the next slide here, the South Shore Educational Collaborative. That's in Hingham. That was a 50,000 square foot industrial building that we turned into a 90,000 square foot special needs school. And I can tell you, every time I walk through that school, it's one of the most gratifying and humbling experiences of my life. It is, I would encourage anyone to go tour that school and see the amazing work that they do there with a really remarkable population of special needs youngsters. And we are especially proud of the fact that we're able to create that facility and that we're able to give back to the community by operating it for the school. So look, that's kind of a flavor of the projects that we work on and what we do. One thing I want to emphasize to you and that I really hope you take away from tonight in terms of, well, who's FoxRock? Every single project we've ever done, every single building we've ever transformed, we still own. And we will still own it decades from now. We don't do anything short-term. Everything we do because we want it to be good for us and good for our community long-term. And that's the approach we take to Whitwell. And look, we feel like this is a real challenge. And we're going to talk about some of the challenges tonight. The fact of the matter is, everyone here and everyone on our team, we all have a very real sense that this is most likely the most important project we're ever going to work on. And when you get up every day with that in the back of your head, it's very exciting. It's very scary. It's a commitment to you and to the community that we take very seriously. And that's part of why we're here tonight, to tell you that's who we are and that's what's important to us. So I'm going to hand this off to my teammate Chris, who's going to talk some more about a little bit the specifics of the project.
So thanks for having us tonight. These guys got the easy part, talking about values, and I'll get into specifics. But so, as Jason mentioned, you know, this is the most important thing we're working on as part of our due diligence and really getting into it. We spent as much time evaluating whether, you know, we had the ability to take it on. We think clearly yes, because we know this is a process, and I think this site in particular was widely marketed for a number of months, and I think a lot of developers and other operators, frankly, maybe wouldn't be as up to the challenge of doing a collaborative development process with an active neighborhood association. We're inviting that as part of this process, and I think if we go to the next slide, I'll maybe talk a little bit about the specifics. I know this has been reported, and some of it has been tied with what's going on down at Quincy Center. So I think my job right now is just giving an overview of, you know, really some of the particulars, and I think the Q&A, you know, will probably relate to some of that. So I'll do my best to go high level. So really, when we started looking at this, it was an interesting situation for us. We don't have the history that we all have with Stewart in terms of dealing with them as a seller. You know, they had really abandoned the property as a hospital and decided it wasn't going to work well before we came aboard. So they were operating out of a small portion of the hospital, as you know, for emergency services. And so that was a big part of the discussion we had with them, because I know what they're doing up there now isn't perfect. And they've, you know, been here for just a little bit, but they are providing service up here now. So to start with, you know, they will be providing emergency services there for 5 years. and that it keeps the continuity. Other than that, you know, to be honest, this was, you know, having some medical experience, talking to some medical users in Boston. Jason mentioned, hey, how come this stuff isn't in Quincy? It's a question we often ask ourselves, having based here and having deep roots in that medical community. It really is for lack of Class A product. And so we viewed this location with phenomenal development potential, if we could, you know, do it in a responsible way, which we can get into. Oh, that's the first time I've ever heard that.
Yeah. Nobody ever said it to me.
Yeah.
So.
So really, you know, we don't have any specific plans. We're going through this process. This is step one. That would be irresponsible for us to say, hey, what is this going to be? We can talk through, and there's a later slide on, you know, the definition of medical uses that I know was reported, so I know you have a lot of questions about that. But really, we were buying the potential, using our track record and the community and, you know, access to transportation, and saying, hey, look, we'll go through a community development process, figure out what we can do there, and then go out and widely market it to the medical community, which is our plan, and that's what we'll work hard on once we come to a consensus on what does make sense there. These guys would, I'd be remiss if I didn't mention that they put hodgepodge in the slide, but really, you know, I don't know how many of those buildings are reusable. Smarter people than me will figure that out. We thankfully have them on our team, but, you know, we can talk through the specifics as we get to the end. So in terms of what was reported, and, you know, the focus of this meeting is 114 Whitwell. It's the focus of a lot of our attention. Frankly, it's the only property we own. As you saw, we were the designated developer for the Ross parking parcel in Quincy Center. There seemed to be some confusion. I mean, really the rationale for that is, you know, we're not medical users. When we talk to medical users, some of them would prefer dense urban sites. Some of them love, you know, the scale of what's already existing at 114 Woodwell. But we, both of these are transit-oriented sites, and, you know, we thought doing both of these together made a lot of sense as we ramp up our marketing efforts. When we sit down with these users, they like to see a nice presentation, and they like to see options. So we look forward to working with the city in understanding exactly what the particular terms of, you know, potentially what we do down in Quincy Center are. But right now, you know, we own 114 Whitwell. That transaction stands on its own, and it's going to take up a lot of our time and attention, and is a reason why. So, medical uses. This is another thing. We keep talking about medical uses, what that is, and that's an extremely broad term, as you can tell from this definition. And part of that is, like I said, you know, it's somewhat atypical for a real estate company to come in, not have a specific plan, and say, hey, we're going to do 2 million square feet of medical use up here, and then have everyone react to that. We think we have an idea of what users want to go there, but to be honest with you, we're going to take the feedback that we get tonight and some of the process that Chet's going to talk about in terms of how we want this to work going forward, and really build that into our plans. As Jason mentioned, we have a long-term outlook. Never sold the property. We all live on the South Shore. So we'll be your neighbor for a while. But we have some urgency around wanting to develop that property and redevelop it, and that we don't think, you know, it's essentially blighted right now in some respects, and we don't think that that's helpful for anybody. So we'll go through the process a little bit, and as we get into it, this is a definition that I'm sure you've seen, and we can unpack this. But this is our best stab at, you know, really what we consider medical uses. So this is on our website. As we get into it, Chet's going to talk about it. If you have any questions as this comes up, you know, We're all available. There's contact information on the website. So our goal is to provide you with as much information as you want, and that helps make sense of all this. So that's really a kind of a broad overview about the project and some of what was reported. As we get into the Q&A, happy to answer any specific questions that we can. But for now, I think Chet's going to briefly talk about the process we envision, and then we'll open it up to questions.
Can everybody in the back hear me? Is that okay? Great. All right. The big question, where do we go from here? So tonight is step one. It's preliminary. It's not functory. We're here to establish ourselves as individuals and a company and start a dialogue. We envision a process in which the community has a seat at the table, as does the council, the mayor's office, the market, potential tenants. But we, as we are actively going to market to test who is out there, we envision this process. This is the first of numerous community meetings. We have some feasibility studies that we're initiating this month. We're assembling a project team to take on a project of this scale. We will then get into the design phase. More importantly than the bullet points here is that we're really optimistic about this project and really do hope to hear from you tonight about questions, comments, anything we can answer therein. At the beginning, we promised that we're here to listen, and that means I need to stop talking. So in the interest of doing that, I am going to first talk about our website at 114whitwell.com. There were sign-up sheets outside as well, but if you sign up for our email address, for our email newsletter, that's the best way to stay in the loop. And we'll leave it up here. Our goal here is an engaged, collaborative planning process where this community has a voice. So Ed Marchand, who's on our team, who's up front here, is going to facilitate the Q&A. I ask that everyone try to keep their comments or questions brief in the interest of giving everyone a chance to speak. We will do our best to answer your questions. Anything we don't have good answers for tonight, we will follow up with Q&A on the website. And we'll go from there. Yeah, please raise your hand. Ed will go around.
Just really quickly before we start the Q&A, thank you very much. As many of you probably can tell, this is a very, very, very early meeting, very preliminary discussion about what possibly could go there. And I just want to reiterate for folks that throughout the process over the coming months, that there will be other public forums. This particular site is a PUD, it's a planned urban development, so anything that really goes there has to go to the council, being a PUD. So, and that also means site plan review through the planning board. And so there'll be plenty of opportunity as the project starts to come together and more definite, more concrete uses and so on come together, that public input will be welcomed and asked for. So by no means is this your one shot to say anything or to ask questions. Again, it's a very preliminary meeting, and as you can see, I mean, there's not a whole lot of meat on the bones, so to speak, at this point, but we felt it important to sort of come to the neighborhood, introduce FoxRock, as well as just some of the possibilities and what might happen. So no worries if you don't know or you want to be more involved in this process. There will be plenty of opportunity to do that moving forward when we have some concrete plans and projects to actually look at. So but I just wanted to reiterate that for folks here. And with that, I guess we'll take questions again.
Great. Do we have the first question?
I was just wondering, what's the possibility that this will turn into yet another condo or apartment development?
As you said, it's very early, and as we've spoken to tonight, that's not in our DNA as a company. We are committed to the medical use up there and pursuing that very actively moving forward. But, and as you saw the movies, it's not included in the definition.
Yeah, thank you. So, I will say two points on that, really. So one DO point I did mention, and as you read, we certainly worked with the city and the mayor's office on, there was a right of reverter, and it was very convoluted and complicated. And one thing, we did discuss with the city, our vision is to think very big here in terms of bringing a medical user to Quincy to provide the kind of care that people want down here. So that, we're thinking very big in terms of maybe even bringing some medical users down from Boston that maybe haven't thought about this yet. And so I think as we get into the process, and I'd encourage you to, participate and keep up to date, we aren't thinking about putting the first user in that comes here. I'll be very honest with you. As soon as this was announced, there were some type of users that I think some people in this room would object to that we, didn't call back and are not focused on that right now. We agreed to spend a sizable sum of money to promote medical users, and we didn't take that on lightly. If we wanted to right off the bat target the type of users that I think you're concerned about, we wouldn't have agreed to do that because they look for a home where they can find it. And so I think as the process unfolds, I don't know where we ultimately end up, but I know where we're starting and what we're going to work hard on, and that is to bring a use there that we can be proud of, and that everyone in this room will be happy about, or at least not completely. opposed to. I think it's going to be a process, and so we're looking forward to it.
So I'm all for having something in that area. I'd much rather have something there than have an 80% entirely. My thoughts are more around sort of the whole view of putting something there, not just focusing on the property and the building, but how does that affect traffic in the area? How does that affect just in general the strain and the stress on our particular infrastructure we have here, because it is getting quite strained and stressed as it is, and more people will be moving in. It's a great neighborhood, we can't keep it to ourselves, I get that. But just planning ahead for that to make sure that we're doing it intelligently. And what does that look like in the other properties you have developed, and how they can implement it into a holistic view within those properties?
Yeah, thanks. Great question. I think, as Councilor Hughes mentioned, as part of the planning process, traffic and those kind of things will be fully vetted, and will have a huge impact on what goes there. And we'll have studies done, and that'll be a massive consideration. In terms of other properties we've worked on, things like traffic and parking and are always, kind of high on the list of things you think about. And so I would say as we get into it and as we kind of narrow in, those things will come into focus. And, the city has, unfortunately, there's been some great development in the city. And the city previous to this has, been very thoughtful about you know, some of the rules and regulations surrounding development. So I think we're working within narrow parameters, you know, based on what people before us think is responsible. And so I think we're looking forward to kind of getting those issues, and it'll certainly be a huge factor.
Thank you for your presentation. I have a couple of questions, so maybe I'll stop and let you answer them first. So first, the footprint is 15 acres. What is the square footage of the buildings that occupy that site right now?
It's a little over 350,000 square feet.
Okay, so are you going to be renovating it depending on the uses that might be going in? Are you going to then, if so, what is your total budget that you're going to allow? Or are you going to pass that cost on, which would also impact what goes in there?
Yeah, so in terms of renovating it, I mean, I think there's some, been, frankly, there's some buildings there that it will not make any sense to renovate, and they're functionally obsolete. An option is some medical users like new buildings, and they need it for, you know, regulations and what they're responsible for. So, and in terms of passing those costs on, I mean, it's really a function of the rent, we get the lease. So, I think those are items to be determined.
Right. Your comments in your other buildings that you present were 90,000 square feet in one of the places that you show. This is far bigger. So you're really looking to potentially utilize all of that space, because 15 acres is a large parcel of land. So unless you're going to be using it mostly for parking, I'm curious as to what you're going to be doing with all of that land. And as others have brought up, the concerns are, as medical users, it could range from a variety of things. Right now, there's a large homeless population in Quincy, shelters, et cetera, all are necessary, but it's very difficult. We abut directly the hospital. And there have been incidences where people have wandered through the fence into our yard, into our garage. I've kindly walked them back, but it's just a concern that most neighbors have, not in opposition to development, but more so with what goes there. So I think I've heard that from you. But as you pointed out, the roots of your organization are here. I'm curious how many currently live in Quincy. So we are the direct neighbors. We live on the South Shore. We live in this area. So thank you.
Thanks.